Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
Once again, you're welcome to the presence of the Almighty God. We appreciate Him for what He did yesterday, making us realize that we need to heed principles and not just wasting our times on acrobatic displays of crying and weeping and jumping up and saying we are praying when we have not obeyed His instructions. So, brethren, we need to hearken to the word of God for blessings to be our portion. So today is Thursday, the 28th day of September. And the topic says, heed this invitation. The mighty God is giving you an invitation. When you know the worth of someone giving you an invitation, it will let you know how to dance to the tune of that particular invite. When presidents invite some people, they dare not miss it because they will say, ah, it is the president that invited me. When the chief of your place invites you, my chief invited, but now the one that is giving the invitation is the Lord of Lords, is the King of Kings, is the man of war, Jehovah Nissi, giving you an invitation. So we bow our heads to worship God as we pray. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Alleluia. Alleluia. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Alleluia. 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 You are the mighty God. Oh yes, the great I am. Alleluia. 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 The mighty God, we worship you. The great I am, we worship you. The everlasting Redeemer, we worship you. My rock and my buckler, we worship you. The great deliverer, we worship you. The source of life, we exalt you. Thank you, thank you for making it clear to us yesterday that we need to walk by principles and not just be moved. Be moved by doing things the way we feel. No. But that we should stand by your instructions. And these will open doors unto the blessings for us. So, Father, help we, your children, in obeying you, even to the letter, in the name of Jesus. Let your glory permeate our lives. Let your majesty be revealed. And as you give your invite, even today, Father, everyone listening will acknowledge this particular invitation of yours. In the name of Jesus, we come to drink. We come to the source of life. In the name of Jesus. So touch everyone that will be listening today. And glorify yourself, O God. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. You're welcome to the presence of the Almighty God. The memory verse is taken from John 7:37. John 7:37. And the passage is John 7:37-39. We just read straight. Illustrate. And the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. The Holy Ghost was not yet given because Jesus was not yet glorified. So from this particular passage, you see that the cry of Jesus was to the thirsty believers. The thirsty believers, talking to individuals. Thirsty. And the question is, thirsty of what? Those who are thirsty of the rivers of living water, which is the Holy Spirit. You thirsty of the Holy Spirit? You want more of the Holy Spirit? You want more of the infilling of the Holy Spirit? Huh. This is a sign to us that we need to be filled regularly as of with the apostles of old. The apostles of old, they were not tired of being filled. They were regularly coming to drink. Like in Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2, I read from verse 1. It says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. On the day of Pentecost, they were filled. Everybody were filled with the Holy Spirit, because they've been waiting. They were thirsty. They're asking God, because I've been given the instruction to go and wait in Jerusalem. And they waited. And after this, you see further, more again, after dissipating energy, using the power that the Holy Spirit had given unto them, one thing or the other, and particularly in chapter 4, after the miracle at the gate called Beautiful, and there was a challenge that they were faced, then they now got back to themselves, and they had to pray. They had to pray. And I see chapter 4 of Acts, I read from verse 29. It says, and now, Lord, behold their threatenings, and grant unto thy servants that with all boldness they may speak thy word, by stretching forth thy hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy holy child Jesus. And when they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spake the word of God with boldness. You can see another refilling. They desired it. They were thirsty for it. They want to be more effective, so that the people might know that the God they are serving is genuine, because they have been instructed, don't preach in this name anymore. Never preach in this name anymore. So he said, we need more power to be able to go forth and do that, that we surprise the people. So after dissipation of energy, they required more of the power. And verse 39 of the passage says, but this speak ye of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. See it? When Jesus was taken, the day of Pentecost came, and power started to flow. And since then, brethren, The power has been available. The power has been available. But it says, an invitation was given. In the last days, that great day of the say, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. We can drink from Jesus, and Jesus alone is the source of power. Is the source of power. If anybody comes to you and say, he will contact you, he will connect you with power, ask. Is it from Jesus? If it's not from Jesus, say, out of the way. Out of the way. Because Jesus told the disciples, he told them that they should wait in Jerusalem until they are endued with power from on high. And that was made clear because in verse 8 of Acts chapter 1, Acts 1 verse 8 says, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and of the uttermost part of the earth. Shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. Any power that is not of the Holy Spirit is contrary. And how do you know that the power is of the Holy Spirit? You look at the name, Holy. It's the Spirit of Holiness. It's the Spirit of Holiness that gives the power. When you can see immorality, you can see corruption, you can see a life of that is not straight in any man. And he says, he is working with the power. Check it. That is not from the Holy Spirit. That is not from the Holy Spirit. That's why every one of us must be very careful at this particular end time. From the body of the study, it says, how should one chase 1,000 and two put 10,000 to flight, except their rock had sold them and the Lord has shut them up? One chasing 1,000 and two putting 10,000 to flight. Something went wrong somewhere. It is because one has abandoned them. So from the body of the study, it says, although praying corporately is good, it should never be regarded as a substitute to a vibrant personal prayer life. One chasing 1,000. And two, putting 10,000 to flight. That is powerful. A synergy that is so strong. If one, you'll be chasing 1,000. And two, not just 2,000, not just 4,000, but 10,000. Some people quote the above scriptures to justify remaining at the level of corporate prayers. And as a result, they consider efforts towards personal prayer to be a waste. It is not a wasted effort. My brother, my sister, it is not. Because when God will be dealing with man, he deals with us individually. Even though corporate prayers might be working, but an individual lifestyle is very crucial before God. God wants to relate with us individually and develop a personal relationship with us, just as much as he wants to relate with us as a group. Because, is that it? Forsake not the assembly of one another together. Yes, he wants us to be together. But at the same time, individually, he wants us to be strong. In Isaiah 51 verse 2, he said this to us, look unto Abraham your father and unto Sarah that bear you, for I called him alone and blessed him and increased him. Individual callings. God deals with us individually, even though as a group it might be working. The group of children of God working together, well, God But this individual thing is very crucial. Very crucial. God was dealing with the children of Israel as a group. They were being victorious. But look at what Achan did when he was just the odd man out. He frustrated what God would have done for the group. So, in the group, when an individual is strong, the strength of the group, as individuals get stronger, the group also gets stronger. God called Abraham alone. Even when we are in a group meeting, God still wants to maintain a personal link with each of us. One-on-one before God. God is a personal God. When two brothers came to give an offering to God, the Lord related with them individually. In Genesis 4, 3 to 10, Genesis 4, 3 to 10 is a long passage, but you know this story very well, that Abel and Cain came before the Almighty God with their offering. But they have the same father, and yet God dealt with them individually. How often do you spend time alone with God? How often? Alone with God. Even though we are admonished not to forsake the assembly of one another. Hebrews 10:25 admonish us this way. Not forsaking the assembling of one another together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much more, as we see the day approaching. God here demanding for unity. He wants us to be united. Because unity comes with a very powerful result. The Bible says in the passage, Deuteronomy 32 verse 30, one should chase 1,000, 10 raised to power 3. And two will chase 10 raised to power 4. A powerful result. Powerful result. The difference is so marvelous that when you look at 1,000 and 10,000, the difference is 9,000. 9,000. That is 9 times what a single individual will provide. 9 times 10 raised to power 3. Nine times what an individual can provide. But want to say that as much as this unity is important, personal development is very essential in this strategy. The working of a scissors, for example, when one of the arms of the scissors is not okay, the scissors cannot be efficient. The two arms must be okay for the scissors to be able to have result. So this is where this aspect of personal development comes in. Individually, we must develop ourselves so that when we come together, it will be iron sharpening iron. It will be iron sharpening iron. Not that one will be a liability on the other, trying to pull such others down. So moreover, there are great benefits that comes from staying alone with God. If you look at the example of the widow of the prophet in 2 Kings chapter 4, 1 to 7, 2 Kings chapter 4, 1 to 7, we can see some of the benefits of individual prayers. When she was asked to shut the door on herself, several things happened on her. One of which is that she went in empty but came out full. She went in empty. She came out full because she had time with the Almighty God. She took several empty vessels with her into the room, and all the vessels were filled. Even today, as you personally separate yourself to access the throne of grace, your empty vessels will be made full in the name of Jesus. In today's Bible reading, while attending the Feast of the Jews, the Lord made a call. Although it was made publicly, it was a personal call. He said, anyone who was thirsty should come to him and be filled. If you can cultivate your personal relationship with God by creating regular time to be in his presence, you will always be filled even when you enter his presence empty. Today the Lord is sending you an invitation to come into his presence, and he will fill you up. Your emptiness can be completely swallowed up as you spend personal time with him. Are you ready to have your emptiness filled? How hungry are you? It is your level of hunger and thirst for him that will determine how filled you will get. So, how hungry or thirsty are you? Because see that along with God was practiced even by our Lord Jesus Christ. And on his return, when the disciples had gone, he got a fresh anointing, and he started to walk on water. He started to walk on water to meet with the disciples. So setting about time to pray is very important as an individual. Received the power to go and challenge the king as per the life of idolatry that was in that particular nation. And he said, there will be no rain. Alone with God. So brethren, we've been encouraged today that we will put ourselves right and start to set up our time to be alone with our God for our spiritual growth and for the blessings of God upon our lives. And this will enable us, as we come together, to now have a powerful force that will be able to chase 10,000. So action point says, identify things that are working against your ability to spend time alone with God and prayerfully deal with them. For example, is it the awareness of your television, sitting by television, or by your telephone? Now that you have the handphone, answer it, carry it all about. Even when you are saying, you are praying, and you are looking at the face of your phone, can't you switch off the phone? You say you are praying and you are sending a text message. Can't you switch off? You are praying and then you are connected with the internet. Check it, my brother. Or the life of leisure. I need my rest. I need this. Jesus, even the Lord himself, had time alone with the Father. So we bowed our heads and say, Father, create in me thirst for the Holy Spirit. Create in me thirst for the Holy Spirit. Time to be alone with you. Time to be alone with you. Create in me the thirst for the Holy Spirit. Talk to the Almighty God. So, Father, create in me. Enable me, my Father, my God, to create more time to be alone with you. Enable me, my Father, my God, to create more time to be alone with you. Thirsting for the Holy Spirit. Thirsting for the Holy Spirit. Help me, my Father, my God. Creating more time to be alone with you, my Lord and my God. In order that I will Be filled with the Holy Spirit afresh on daily basis. Help me, faithful Father. Help me, mighty Father. Help me, eternal Rock of Ages. Help me to create more time to be alone with you. Help me, mighty Father. Help me, King of Glory. Help me. Without glorified, O God. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Mighty and eternal Father, we have seen today, Lord, that as individuals, we need to be strong in you. And it is by this, my Lord and my Father, that when we come together, we'll be able to do greater things. Our Lord, we pray that this understanding will come for us in the name of Jesus, that individually we have time with you. Individually, we will study the word. Individually, we will pray. Individually, we will seek your face. Individually, my Father, my God, that as we stand strong with your help, by the time we come, that passage will be fulfilled, as it is written in Deuteronomy 32, verse 30, that one will chase 1,000 and two shall put 10,000 to flight. Father, we pray that you will help us to manifest this from this moment on in the name of Jesus. Glory be to your name, O God. Help us to grow and grow more in you. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Join us as we sing, Take My Life. God bless you.
Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it. Sing out. Yeah.